My name is Jerry Norton. I'm 55 years old. I had a 30-year career in rodeo business as a rodeo bullfighter.
Here's Jerry Norton now, Mitchell, South Dakota.
That job, you're like the Secret Service for the bull rider. Your job is to step in there and take the shot if somebody's in trouble, if they're going to get hit by the bull. Well, that's our job, and as you can imagine, there's a lot of things that can happen, and it gets pretty violent.
Hey. Well, I think that, you know, just being new on the tour, he's starting to get a lot of confidence.
Throughout that career, I know at least 20 concussions that are documented. And I imagine that there's a lot more than that. And because of that, I ended up having a lot of struggles. It was years after I was done, probably 8 to 10 years, it seemed to be coming on as I look back. I didn't realize it at the time, but I was very irritable. I was having trouble with my memory, trouble with my concentration. I could be in the middle of a sentence and forget what I was about to say, but more than that, I'd forget the whole subject and I couldn't recall it. I found myself doing different things to cover. I was getting kind of scared inside, actually. I can admit that I was getting scared that I'd be found out because I was really struggling and I didn't know what was going on. There'd be times of outbursts of anger that I had no idea that it was coming. I wasn't getting upset, but boom, I'd be angry or I'd get really angry. And it was getting to the point where it really scared me. I felt very hopeless, and I wanted to crawl in a hole and disappear because I knew what some of these other guys that have had CTE and had a history of a lot of concussions, I had a lot of symptoms that these guys had that ended up with CTE, and it was a very dark end of their life, and I didn't want that for myself. But the cool thing is the doctor said you can heal the brain. That's when I perked up and like, all right, tell me some more. What are you talking about? The doc explained that hyperbaric oxygen therapy can help regenerate or regrow parts of the brain that are dormant, that aren't necessarily firing like it should. So I signed up for the hyperbaric treatments. I hop in there, I have my first treatment, and I didn't have any troubles breathing. I thought, well, maybe my chest will be tight or something like that. I just kicked back and watched some TV that was up by my feet, and I guess enjoyed the ride, you might say. I went through like 10, and I'm thinking, man, I'm not really feeling anything. And I get to 15 treatments in, and Dr. Luistro checks in with you, he's here all the time, and I pulled him to the side and I said, Doc, I'm not really sure about this because I'm not experiencing anything. I don't feel any sharper. I'm not feeling anything. I'm not experiencing any changes. And he took a deep breath. He says, well, this is what's really going on, and we're playing the long game. You're building nerve tissue as well as venous tissue, growing new blood vessels and new neural pathways, and really regenerating parts of my brain that were damaged and that had little blood flow to them. So I, all right, Doc, let's go. I'm not sold yet, but let's go some more. So it was about 10 treatments later. I was around 25, 26 treatments in, and I could tell something was different. I couldn't put my finger on it, but I could tell something was different. And I didn't say anything. I thought, well, you know, I'm hopeful. I want something to happen. Am I making it up in my head? I went a couple more treatments, and I was feeling more alert and more just into it in life, had more pep, I guess. happiness seemed to be coming back. And so I talked to my wife after 27, 28, 29 treatments in, somewhere in there, and I said, Benita, I don't know what it is, but something's happening with these treatments. She says, yeah, I know. I'm like, what are you talking about? You know, why didn't you say anything? But then it dawned on me, like, wait a second. What do you mean you know? What are you noticing? That? Because I just noticed something. She said, well, you're a lot more flexible. You're not as rigid as you were. You're easier to get along with. I'm thinking, well, that's pretty good. We'd been married probably 5 years at the time, and she said, what's really cool is I'm having deeper conversations now than I've ever had with you. I'm having deeper conversations than ever. And I agreed. It was pretty cool. I called and talked to a brother of mine, and I was telling him, I said, man, these treatments seem to be doing something. I don't know what it is. And he said, yeah, I know. Like, what do you know over the phone? He said, before when you would talk, he said, I could tell you talk slower, and I could tell you were thinking about what you were about to say as you're in the sentence. So you talk slower as you're putting the words together. He said, now you just talk at a faster rate of speech. You're into it. You're with it. And that was like a big shot in the arm to hear those two people give me the feedback that other people are noticing something. So full throttle ahead, went through and did 40 treatments. And as I was going through, I felt more alert, more alive. I was more relaxed. I wasn't as intense. You know, the temper popping up was going away, or was almost gone away completely. I just felt better. So then I looked at how am I doing in my work performance, how am I doing in life, and I'm better able to handle the workload that was put on me when I was back to work. Probably handle nearly double the workload and the stress that I did a year before. And to me, that was an extremely pleasant surprise. My experience at Healing with Hyperbarics was pretty seamless. I felt very supported. And one thing that really struck me with the staff at Healing with Hyperbarics is their sincerity of care, their genuineness, and they're direct. They didn't pull any punches. They told me like it was, and I'm a guy who appreciates that. Really, as I look back and through this whole experience, it's like I got my life back. When they told me that in Chicago and I saw my brain scan and they told me what that looked like, what it was telling them, I didn't have any hope. And through this experience, I have hope, and I'm excited about the future, and I'm just excited about life. And I'm very grateful for hyperbaric oxygen therapy.